Would you like to learn how to film mixed reality videos of VR apps and VR games with your Oculus Quest? In today's video, I will show you how you can do it at home with any previous knowledge of programming or filming. As a side note, if you're a VR professional looking for high-quality mixed reality filming services, get in touch with us at info@alexgonzalez.tech. We'll be happy to film your VR app or VR game. Alright, let's get started with the tutorial. So first of all, there are two programs that allow you to film mixed reality. First, there's a program called LIF that is completely free at the time this video is published. It's the program I always use and the program I will be teaching you in this tutorial. The second program that films mixed reality is the official Oculus Mixed Reality Capture software. I don't use it because from what I saw on other YouTube tutorials, the Oculus Mixed Reality Capture supports only a few games. Besides, the software is not very polished and you find bugs, but that might change in the future, we will see. Once we chose the LIF software, the next question is, what hardware do I need to film mixed reality? First of all, you will need a powerful computer with an NVIDIA graphics card 1070 or higher and an Intel i7 CPU. My videos, for example, are filmed with an NVIDIA 2070S. In case you don't have a powerful computer and don't want to invest in one, I suggest waiting for the relaunch of the LIF iOS app. But bear in mind, the quality of the videos filmed wirelessly won't be as high as I will explain in a minute, with a powerful computer and a link cable, obviously. Let's move on. Once you have your Oculus Quest connected via link cable to your high specs computer, the next thing you will need is a green chroma, like this one. If you don't have a chroma, you can also use a depth camera like a Kinect or an iOS device with the A12 Plus processor. Bear in mind that depth cameras won't unfortunately offer the same clean results as using a chroma, because they don't measure the depth super accurately yet. This is an example of a video capture with an iPhone and no green chroma. If you do get a chroma, then you will be able to film with any webcam, for example a Logitech webcam. But if you're looking for a higher quality and have a higher budget, then get a GoPro or a DSLR camera. I personally use a GoPro Hero 4 because it was the one I already had at home, and I'm thinking of upgrading to a Sony A6000 that costs 600 euros. In case you film with a GoPro or a DSLR camera, you will need an additional component. You will need one of these capture cards. I use the Elgato 4K and I am very happy with it. But if you decided to use a webcam, you will need a capture card. I know I mentioned many alternative equipment and you might be confused, so to wrap up, the first option and cheapest one is getting an iPhone X and waiting for the LIF iOS beta to be reopened. The second option is getting a gaming computer, Oculus Link and a depth camera. Third option is a gaming computer, Oculus Link, webcam and green chroma. And the fourth option is the one that gives you the best results and the one I will explain in this tutorial. That is a gaming computer, an Oculus Link, a video camera, a capture card and a green chroma. Now let's move on to my filming studio where I will tell you how to connect all the cables. Come with me. Welcome to my mixed reality filming studio. Sorry for the echo here. So this is it. This is my green chroma, lightning, the camera and the computer there. My chroma is 3 meters wide times 5 meters long. And I use tape to tape the chroma to the floor. I use a green cloth because I need to be able to, when I finish filming, to take everything out, because this room is used for other purposes as well. If you can have the studio fixed, then you might be interested in just painting the walls in this green chroma and getting for the floor some green foams. That would be perfect. Your chroma fabric needs to have the least wrinkles as possible. This is my GoPro Hero 4. I have it on a tripod. Here fixed. As you see, there are two cables connected to the GoPro. One is the power connected via USB. It's charging the whole time the battery so that you don't need to rely on the battery. And the other cable is the HDMI. My GoPro has a micro HDMI, so I had to get this adapter. And then from micro HDMI to HDMI. And then the HDMI out of the GoPro goes straight into my capture card. Don't be afraid of getting an integrated capture card like this one, because the installation is really easy. The manufacturer tells you how to do it and it just takes 5 minutes, so I prefer them over the external capture cards. I will show you my light. This is an LED light from Neewer, very cheap one, like 80 euros, I guess. The good part is that it doesn't get hot in the summer, so because it's LED. For recording mixed reality with a green chroma, you want to have as much light as possible. At least two of these lights, one for lighting the chroma and the one for lighting the person. If you're just in the beginning, don't worry too much about the lights. If you have just ceiling lights, it will do the job in the beginning. The result won't be great, but yeah, get a light maybe in a second step if you're in a budget. But definitely you will need to get a good lighting to achieve proper results. Now you need to get your Oculus Quest with a link cable. This is just an unofficial link cable, very cheap from Amazon. I will leave a link in the description. And yeah, don't worry, it's not the official one. It just works as good as the official one for much cheaper. Make sure to get it up to 3 meters, otherwise the signal gets lost. And make sure to connect it to an USB 3 port. Then you need to connect your monitor to your graphics card. All right, now that you have all the equipment, let's talk about what VR apps can be filmed in mixed reality. I did a previous video talking in depth about the topic. Anyway, I will do a quick recap of that video right now. You can film any Unity or Unreal app that has the Leaf SDK integrated. You can find a list of around 150 VR games and apps that have the Leaf SDK integrated on this website, leaf.tv/apps. The most filmed games are Beat Saber, O-Shape, and Superhot, among others. If you're a VR developer, you can download the Leaf SDK for free here in leaf.tb/download. Integrate the SDK in your VR game or app and enable mixed reality filming. At the moment, only Steam VR games and apps can be filmed with Leaf. In the near future, though, Oculus Store exclusive games and apps will be filmable as well. The Leaf team is working on it. Okay, now that you have the film equipment and the game or app compatible with Leaf, it's time to install some programs in your computer. I am assuming you already installed Steam, SteamVR, and the Oculus software. Now go to Steam and download Leaf.
And once it's downloaded, open it, click on Launch Compositor, and here you have Leaf open. Go to Camera, Add Camera. Here select Video Camera, or if you're using the Leaf iOS app, go for that, or the Kinect, go for that. Here select your capture card and the quality. You're filming in full HD, so this quality. Now the camera gets activated, you need to center the image. Now click on settings, crop and flip, and crop the image to hide all the parts you don't have in chroma, like that, perfect. Now take your Oculus Quest and make a very big play space that goes behind your camera and behind your computer. Then allow Oculus Link Beta. Now let's calibrate your camera. Press the trigger once to initiate the calibration. You should now see a big red cross in the middle of your view. Then bring your controller all the way up to the lens of the camera and press the trigger. And then step as far back into your play space as you can, or until distance indicator turns green. And then repeat the clicks in both corners using the same alignment as before. If you have tried getting your clicks as accurate as possible but your calibration is still a little bit off, you can try fine-tuning your calibration using the manual adjustments. If your calibration is widely off, make sure you are maintaining tracking throughout the entire calibration process. As you see, the movement of the controllers doesn't match, so you will need to adjust the latency. In my case, my latency is around 100, but depending on the app or the game, the heavier the app, the higher the latency will be. And then you will need to adjust the position of the controllers, as I'm doing, with the X, Y, and Z axis. So you need to play around with these numbers until physical and real controllers match. And you're happy with the calibration like that. That's pretty accurate already, and you're good to go. Now click on Save the calibration, click on Viewfinder and activate it. The viewfinder is a window inside the headset that allows you to watch what you're filming. Then click on Output, select the resolution, Full HD, and the FPS, 60 FPS. Then click on Capture, select the game you wanna play and film. Live enabled are the ones that work best, and legacy support and possibly supported many times don't work at all. Once you're ready, click on Launch, and you will see the game will open. Beat Saber has the Leaf SDK very well integrated, and you see it match. Okay, you're almost there, just a couple more things.
Bear with me, I will tell you now how to put the center of your play space in front of your GoPro or DSLR camera. So you need to install OpenVR Advanced Settings if you don't have it yet on your computer. You can get it for free on Steam searching for OVR Advanced Settings. Just install it and then you can open it from the menu button of your Oculus Quest. Then click the Advanced Settings symbol. Now walk into the middle of the chroma in front of your camera, your GoPro or your DSLR camera. Play around with the X and Z axis until your central position matches the center of the play space, and the Y axis, you don't need to touch it, will be correct. Below the Z axis, you can rotate the play space and get the best looking angle. I want to make clear that the GoPro, for example, stays on its tripod the whole time at the same position. What rotates, it's the play space, okay? Lastly, the last step of the tutorial is to capture the Leaf output window you see here. I personally use OBS capture software. At the end, the video should look like this.
Alright, now you're ready to do your first mixed reality shootings. Congratulations for arriving so far, you deserve a beer! If you have any questions or get stuck in the process, let me know in the comments and I will try my best to help you. This was my beginner's mixed reality tutorial for Oculus Quest. I am thinking of doing an advanced tutorial on the topic and talk about, for example, best filming practices, best angles to capture, how to rotate the camera around you, how to know if an app has a problem with the Leaf integration, and many more stuff. Let me know in the comments if you would be interested in that tutorial. Remember, if you're a professional looking for high quality mixed reality filming services, get in touch at info@alexgonzalez.tech. Thanks so much for watching. You can subscribe to my channel by clicking here. And this is another video of mine that YouTube suggests to watch next. See you next time. Adios.